Welcome to the DoubleACS Daily News. Over the years, the all-volunteer Attleboro Garden Club has made an effort to maintain and grow gardens and other vegetation throughout the city. They're inviting new members to join, and we spoke with one of the organizers to find out more.
My name is Jocelyn Veria, and I'm the co-president of the Attleboro Garden Club. We're 45 members strong, and we're a working club. We take care of the Anderson Rose Garden here at Capron Park, and the blooms were absolutely gorgeous this year. It has been the site for many a wedding in the past. So we take care of the roses, we prune them, we replace any that didn't make it through the winter. We also take care of a memorial garden which we funded, which is near the White Gazebo and the other side of Capron Park, also a facility used for celebrations. Inside the zoo, we recently renovated a small garden called Caitlin's Garden, dedicated to a young lady from Mansfield called Caitlin. Her life tragically ended 10 years ago. We also take care of the traffic island at Gilbert Perry Square and all the gardens around the Attleboro Public Library. We started early spring. We started putting the preen down to control the weeds, and we started cultivating, and then we had to replace about 4 rose bushes, so Lee bought some new ones with our funds. We fund everything ourselves through our dues and our plant sale. Unfortunately, we're unable to have a plant sale this year because of COVID-19. So it takes a couple of weeks for us to have our teams get together, and then weekly we come over and make sure everything is spruced up. We usually meet, we have teams. For the Rose Garden, we have teams that work for each section. So we email each other when we're going to meet at the Rose Garden to do our work. And we also do the same thing for Gilbert Perry Square. We get together one time in the spring and one time in the fall. We also water it weekly because there is no water source. The same thing with the library garden. The library garden we take care of, and we contact each other by email. We also have a team that's dedicated just to the library gardens. I also want to give a big shout out to Lee Gazzo, because it's under Lee's guidance that we've renovated the Rose Garden, and she does an excellent job. We have a website. You can go to Attleboro Garden Club on Facebook, and it talks about membership. It's $40 a year. Our dues are $40 a year. And we also provide lunches at our day meetings. Our day meetings are the first Tuesday of every month at 11:45 a.m. and the second Wednesday in the evening at 6:30 of every month. And we usually meet at the Sweet House. Of course, with the concerns about the coronavirus, our first meeting is in October, so we're going to have to keep our eyes and ears open to see if we're going to be able to serve food or if we're going to have to send out for boxed lunches. We have speakers come in that talk on a variety of subjects, all relating to gardening. And we just have an excellent time. It's a great club. We all get along. It's a wonderful opportunity to meet a dynamic group. So we'll be putting out flyers. If anybody's interested in joining, there'll be some advertisements in the Sun Chronicle. And if you would like to join, we'd love to have you. Our club is very active. Check us out on Facebook, Attleboro Garden Club. Thank you.